Till now, we discussed the hardware architecture, functional building blocks of 8051 microcontroller, pin details of 8051 microcontroller, addressing modes, and instruction set. In this video, we will be discussing the I/O ports, timers, serial control registers, and interrupts. Let us see one by one. The 8051 has four important ports: port 0, port 1, port 2 and port 3. These ports allow the microcontroller to connect with the outside world. The four ports of 8051 microcontrollers have certain specific functions and corresponding features. In this video, we will take a look at the purpose of each of these ports. First, what are the features of four ports of 8051 microcontroller? The first feature is each port has 8 pins, thus the 4 ports jointly comprise 32 pins. All ports are bidirectional. They are constructed with a D-type output latch. They have output drivers and input buffers. We can modify their functions using software and hardware that they connect to the microprocessor. Then to configure ports as an input port, 1 must be written to that port. Then to configure it as an output port, 0 must be written to it. Let's see port 0 features. Port 0, the address is 80. Port 0 has D-type latch, unidirectional buffer and 2 field effect transistors at each pin. It does not have an internal pull-up resistor. An external pull-up resistor is needed when port 0 is defined as an output port. Okay, port 0 of the 8051 has two main functions. It is used as a simple input-output port and to access external memory in conjunction with port 2. The functions of the port 0 are: when we use port 0 as an input port, the internal latch should know that is being used for input, and thus a digital 1 is written at the port address of 80. This turns off the transistor, causing the pin to float in high impedance state, connecting it to the input buffer. We can read data from read pin data or read latch bit. When we use port 0 as an output port, the latch programmed to 0 will turn on. Consequently, the FET will connect to the ground signal. We will require an external pull-up resistor. Okay, that resistor value may be 10 kilo ohm. That is given for logic 1 for using port 0 as an output port. For access external memory, when the 8051 wants to access external memory, the address for the memory generates due to port 0 and port 2. We get the lower half of the address port, port 0, and upper half from port 2. So this is done using ALE pulses, which help to latch the address to the external bus. Once done, the port 0 goes back to the being an input port to read data from the memory. Port 0 has a lot up its sleeve. From reading data to address, it does a lot of things for the microcontroller. Therefore, it is imperative for us to get a deeper understanding of the working of this port. To configure port 0 as an input port, the internal bus writes 1 to the D flip-flop and the control pin is set to 0, that is upper fetch is off, that is the multiplexer is connected to Q dash of the D flip-flop as the control pin is 0. Due to this, the pin is connected to the input buffer, which can be read to get the input data. To use the port as an output port 0 is written to the D flip-flop with the control signal being set to 0. This enables the lower FET and disables the upper FET. Due to this, pin gets connected to the ground and a 0 is returned to the output device. To write a 1 to the external device, the microcontroller writes 1 to the D flip-flop, which drives the pin to a high impedance state as it is not connected to either VCC or ground signal. So, to solve the problem, a pull-up resistor is connected to the output pin, which pulls the value to plus 5 volt or logic 1. For reading address or data from external memory, the control bit is set to 1, which connects the multiplexer to data or address pin. The ALE pin is used to latch the address, and once that is, then the port is used for data transfer operation. So this is about port 0 details. The next one is port 1. The port 1 functions are addresses 90. Port 1 has 1 D latch, 2 unidirectional buffers, 1 field effect transistor and 1 internal pull-up resistor at each pin. It has only one function, that is to act as an input or output port. When port 1 is functioning in the capacity of an input port, a digital 1, that is FF, is written to the latch. At 90, this turns off the transistor and this pin floats in a high impedance state. Okay, then consequently, it connects to the input buffer. When port 1 is functioning in the capacity of an output port, the latch is given a low signal, that is 0,0. This turns the field effect transistor. Then the pull-up resistor is off and the port is used as output port. So this is about port 1 function. Then port 2. Port 2 addresses 1,0. Port 2 has D-type latch, 1 field effect transistor and an internal pull-up resistor with 2 unidirectional buffers and a control logic block. Its main function are kind similar to those of port 0. It can be used as an input-output port and can access external memory in conjunction with port 0. The only difference here is the port 2, we use 1 field effect transistor with an internal pull-up resistor instead of 2 field effect transistors, that is in port 0. Port 2 is used in conjunction with port 0 to generate the upper address of the external memory location that needs to be accessed. However, one key difference is that it does not need to turn around and get a 1 in the latch immediately for input as in port 0. It can remain stable condition. Okay. So these are the details about port 2. Then port 3. The port 3 features are addresses D0. The third port of 8051 has D type latch. In addition to that, it has a 3 unidirectional buffers, a FET with an internal pull-up resistor. In addition, it also have a NAND gate connected to the FET. Then port 3 performs 2 main functions, as we will see here. Functions of port 3, that is just like port 2, port 3 can function as an input output port. The alternate functions are 4-3 0th pin, that is receive data, 4-3 first pin, transmit data, 4-3 second pin, interrupt 0, 4-3 third pin, that is interrupt 1, 4-3 fourth pin, timer 0, 4-3 fifth pin, timer 1, 4-3 sixth pin, write signal, 4-3 seventh pin, read signal. Okay, so receive data is used for serial input port, that is port 3 0th pin. Then transmit data, this is used for serial output port, that is port 3 first pin. Then INT 0 is nothing but this is used for an external interrupt 0, that is port 3 second pin. Then interrupt 1, this is used for external interrupt 1. Then T0, that is a timer 0 external input, that is a timer 1 external input. Then write signal, external data memory write strobe. Read signal is nothing but external data memory read strobe. So these are the details of IO ports of 8051 microcontroller. The next topic is timers of 8051 microcontroller. So already you know 8051 consists of two 16-bit timers. So many microcontroller applications require the counting of external event such as frequency of a pulse train. So this is accomplished using software technique. So two 16-bit up counters, that is timer 0, then timer 1 are used for this. The counters are divided into two 8-bit registers called timer low, that is TL0 and TL1, and timer high, that is TH0 and TH1 bytes. This slide shows the timer control register format. It is an 8-bit register. This register is also called as TCON register. TCON has control bits and flags for the timers in the upper nibble and control bits and flags for external interrupts in the lower nibble. Let's see one by one. The 7th bit, that is TF1. So TF1 is nothing but timer 1 overflow flag set when timer rolls from all 1s to 0. Cleared when processor vectors to execute interrupt service routine located at program address 001B. Then TR1, that is the 6th bit. Timer 1 run control bit. This is called timer run. Timer 1 run control bit set to 1 by program to enable timer to count. Clear to 0 by program to half timer. Does not reset timer operation. Okay, that is 6th bit. Then TF0, that is timer 0 overflow flag set when timer rolls from all 1s to 0, cleared when processor vectors in execute interrupt service routine located at program address 000B. Then TR0. TR0 is nothing but timer 0 run control bit. This bit is set to 1 by program to enable timer to count, and it is cleared to 0 by program to halt timer. Then next bit, third bit, is called as IE1. So IE1 is nothing but external interrupt 1. Third bit, that is IE1, external interrupt 1 edge flag. This flag is set to 1 when a high to low edge signal is received on port 3, that is pin number 3.3. Then it is cleared when the processor vectors to interrupt service routine located at program address 0013. This is not related to timer operation. Then bit 2, that is IT1, external interrupt 1 signal type control bit. SET2-1 by program to enable external interrupt 1 to be triggered by a falling edge of signal. Then this bit is SET2-0 by program to enable a low level signal on external interrupt 1 to generate an interrupt. So that is IT1. Then bit number 1, that is IE0. So this is external interrupt 0 edge flag. So this bit is set to 1 when a high to low edge signal is received on port 3. Pin number 3.2 INT0. Okay, then this pin is cleared when processor vectors to interrupt service routine located at program address 0003. This bit is not related to timer operation. Then 0th bit, that is IT0, external interrupt 0 signal type control bit. This bit is set to 1 by program to enable external interrupt 0 to be triggered by a falling edge signal. Then this bit is set to 0 by program to enable a low level signal on external interrupt 0 to generate an interrupt. So bit addressable TCON register 0th to TCON register 7. So these are the details. The next one is timer mode control, that is T mode register. All counters or timers action can be controlled by bit states in the timer mode operation. Okay, the timer mode is dedicated solely to the two timers. One is a timer 0, another one timer 1. Okay, see here, the first 4 bits, that is first 4 nibble bits is used for timer 0 operation. The next 4 nibbles, that is upper 4 nibbles, is used for timer 1 operation. Let's see one by one. That is a 0th bit or 4th bit. Okay, 0th bit and 4th bit, both are same, that is M0, timer or counter operation. Counter operating mode, select bit. Okay, so M0, bit number 0 and bit number 4 is nothing but M0, timer or counter operating mode, select bit 0. Okay, this bit is set or cleared by program to select the mode operation. The next one is bit number 1 and bit number 5, that is M1, timer or counter operating mode, select bit 1. So this bit is set or cleared by program to select mode. Okay, so using these two bits, the controller select the mode of operation, timer mode of operation. Okay, actually 4 modes are available, mode 0, mode 1, mode 2 and mode 3. Suppose M0 and M1. Okay, these two bits value are 0, means mode 0 is selected. Okay, in case M1 value 0, M0 value 1, that is 0, 1. Okay, 0, 1 means mode 1 is selected. Okay, then 10 condition mode 2 is selected. Then 11 condition mode 3 is selected. Okay, so M0 and M1 is nothing but timer mode selection. The timers can be operated in 4 modes, mode 0, mode 1, mode 2 and mode 3. M0 and M1 value, both values are 0, 0, means mode 0 is selected. 0, 1 condition mode 1 is selected. 10 condition mode 2 is selected. 11 condition mode 3 is selected. Okay, the next one is bit number 2 and 6. Okay, bit number 2 and 6. It is nothing but C/T. That is counter or timer. Bit 2 indicate timer 0, counter operation or timer operation. Bit 6 is nothing but timer 1, counter operation or timer operation. So this bit to set by program to make the timer 1 or 0. Act as counter by counting pulses from external input pins, that is 3.5. 41 or 3.4 for timer 0. And it is a clear to 0 by program to make timer act as a timer by counting internal frequency. So this is the operation of pin number 2 and 6, that is counter or timer. The next one is, that is bit number 3, D3 and D7. It is nothing but gate signal. So here OR gate enable bit, which controls run or stop of timer input or output operation. Okay, run the timer operation or stop the timer operation of input or output. Set to 1 by program to enable timer to run if bit TR1 or TR0 in TCON register is set and signal on external interrupt, interrupt 1 or interrupt 0 pin is high. Then it is cleared to 0 by program to enable timer to run bit, that is TR1 or TR0 in TCON register is set. So this is the function of bit number 3 and bit number 7, that is the D3 and D7, that is gate signal. So these are the functions of timer mode register. The next one, timer mode operation. So already you know the timer can be operated in 4 modes, mode 0, mode 1, mode 2 and mode 3. The 4 modes that are determined by the mode bits, that is M1 and M0 in the T mode register. The frequency of the input given to the entire timer stages is equal to the original oscillator frequency divided by 12, that is the input of the timer circuit. In mode 0, the TL1 acts as 5 bit counter and divides the pulse input by 32, that is 2 power 5 is nothing but 32 in TL register. Okay, then TH acts as an 8 bit counter and TH count is nothing but original frequency, that is equal to original oscillator frequency divided by 12 into 32. So that is the calculation for frequency value in mode 0 operation. So the timer flag is set whenever TH1 goes from FF to 00. Okay, so this is about mode 0. In case of mode 1, mode 1 is similar to mode 0 except TL1 is configured as a full 8 bit counter. In case of mode 0, TL1 acts as 5 bit, whereas here it acts as 8 bit. Okay, that is TF. So this mode is selected when mode bits are set to 01 in timer mode register. Okay, then mode 2. So this is mode 2 diagram. In this mode, the timer mode configures the timer to use only TL1 counter as an 8 bit counter. Then TH1 is used to hold a value that is loaded into TL1 every time. Okay, the TL1 overflows from FF to 00. The timer flag is set when TL1 overflows. Okay, so this is about mode 2. Then mode 3, timers 0 and 1 may be programmed to be in mode 0, 1 or 2 independently of a similar mode for the other timer. So this is not true in case of mode 3. A timer 0 in mode 3 becomes two completely separate 8 bit counters. 2 separately 8 bit counters. TL0 is controlled by the gate arrangement. Okay, so this is gate arrangement, and it is set timer flag, that is a TF0, whenever it overflows from FF to 00. TH0 receives the timer clock, that is the oscillator divided by 12. So under this control of TR1 only, and set the TF1 flag when it overflows. So this is about timer 3 operation. Then the timer 1 may still be used in mode 0, mode 1 and mode 2, while timer 0 in mode 3, with one important exception. No interrupts will be generated by timer 1 while timer 0 is using the TF1 overflow flag. Switching timer 1 to mode 3 cause timers to stop counting, then the control bit TR1 and timer 1 flag, that is TF1, are then used by the timer 0. Okay. Then timer in mode 3 is shown here. So the next topic is serial buffer, that is SBUF. The 8051 has a serial data communication circuit that uses a register SBUF to hold data. SBUF is physically two registers. One is a write only and issued to hold data to be transmitted out of the 8051 via T, that is a T cross D, that is a transmit data. The other is react only and hold received data from external source via R cross D, that is receiver data. The next one is serial porch control register. So here register SCON controls the data communication. Let's see the format. It is a 8-bit register. Okay, starting from D0 to D7. D0th bit act as RI, that is receive interrupt flag, set to 1 at the end of bit 7, at the end of bit 7 time in mode 0, and halfway through the stop bit for other modes, and must be cleared by the program. Then the first bit, that is TI, transmit interrupt flag, set to 1 at the end of bit 7 time in mode 0 and at the beginning of the stop bit for other modes, must be cleared by the program. Okay, then next one, that is the second bit, RBH, that is a received bit 8. Bit 8 of received data in modes 2 and 3, and it also stops the bits in mode 1. It is not used in mode 0. So that is RB8. The next bit, that is TBH, transmitted bit 8. So this bit is set or cleared by program in mode 2 or mode 3 operation. Okay, then fourth bit, that is REN, receive enable bit. It is set to 1 to enable reception, and it is cleared to 0 to disable reception. Then next one is fifth bit, that is SM2, then sixth bit SM1, and seventh bit SM0. So this is nothing but serial port mode selection. Okay, serial port mode selection. So see, SM2 is nothing but multiprocessor communication bit. Okay, SM2, that is the sixth bit, is nothing but multiprocessor communication bit. This bit is a set or cleared by program to enable multiprocessor communication in mode 2 and mode 3. When the bit is set to 1, an interrupt is generated if bit 9 of the received data is 1. Okay. Then no interrupt is generated if bit 9 is 0. If set to 1 for mode 1, no interrupt will be generated unless a valid stop bit is received. Then it is a clear to 0 if mode 0 is in use. So this is about SM2. SM2 is nothing but multiprocessor communication better. The remaining two bits, that is SM0 and SM1 serial port mode, if the bit values are 00 means shift register is used at the baud rate of half. 01 condition, that is mode 1 is nothing but 8 bit UART device is used. Here baud rate value is variable. 10 condition, mode 2 is selected, that is 9 bit UART device is used. Here baud rate value may be frequency divided by 32 or frequency divided by 62. So that is the value of baud rate in case of 10 condition, that is 9 bit UART. 11 condition, that is mode 3 is selected. Here also 9 bit UART device is used. Here baud rate value is variable. Okay, so SM0, SM1 and SM2 all are serial port mode operation. SM2 is used for multiprocessor communication with SM0 and SM1. Once upon mode selection, that is the serial port, either mode 0 or mode 1, mode 2 or mode 3. Suppose 00 means mode 0 is selected, 01 mode 1 is selected, 10 mode 2 is selected, 11 mode 3 is selected. So mode 0 is nothing but shift register is used at the baud rate of half. Mode 1, 8 bit UART device is used at the baud rate, that is variable. Then mode 2, 9 bit UART device is used at the baud rate, frequency divided by 32 or frequency divided by 64. Then mode 3, 9 bit UART, your baud rate is variable. The next one is power control, that is PCON register. Here two operation, one is power down mode, another one idle mode. So power down mode is nothing but the oscillator clock provided to system is off. That is, the CPU and the peripheral clock remains inactive in this mode, that is called power down mode. Ideal mode means only the clock provided to the CPU gets deactivated, whereas the peripheral clock will remain active in this mode. That is called ideal mode. Okay, hence the power saved in power down mode is more than ideal mode. So this is the format of power control register. 0th bit is nothing but ideal mode. 0th bit is nothing but ideal mode. Then first bit, power down bit. Then second bit, general purpose user flag bit 0. Third bit, that is GF1, general purpose user flag bit 1. Then 4, 5, 6 not used, not implemented in case of 8051. Then 7th bit, that is S mode, that is serial baud rate modify bit. Okay, already you know what is idle mode and what is power down mode. Then see the bit number 2, that is GF0, general purpose user flag bit 0. So this bit is set or cleared by program. Similarly, GF1, this bit is set or cleared by program. So this is general purpose user flag bit 1. Okay, then bit number 7, that is a serial baud rate modify bit. So this bit is set to 1 by program to double baud rate using timer 1 for modes 1, 2 and 3. And it is cleared to 0 by program to use timer 1 baud rate. So this is about power mode control, that is PCON register details. The next topic is interrupts of 8051 microcontroller. Interrupts may be generated by internal chip operations or provided by external sources. So any interrupt can cause the 8051 to perform a hardware call to an interrupt. Interrupt handling subroutine, that is located at a predetermined interrupts, may be generated by internal chip operations or provided by external sources. Any interrupt can cause the 8051 to perform a hardware call to an interrupt handling subroutines that is located at a predetermined absolute address in program memory. 5 interrupts are provided in the 8051 microcontroller. 3 of these are generated automatically by internal operation. The 3 interrupts are timer flag, that is TF0, then timer flag 1, that is TF1, and third one is serial port interrupt, either receive interrupt or transmit interrupt. So these 3 are internal interrupt operations. 2 interrupts are triggered by external signals. One is INT0, another one INT1. External hardware interrupt INT0, external hardware interrupt INT1. All interrupt functions can be controlled by the programs using the following registers. One is interrupt enable register, another one interrupt priority registers. Let's see one by one. Interrupt enable register. So here, bits in the interrupt enable register are set to 1 if the corresponding interrupt source is to be enabled, and set to 0 to disable the interrupt source bit. EA is a master or global bit that can enable or disable all the interrupts. Let's see the format. So it is a 8-bit register starting from D0 to D7. So D0 is nothing but EX0, enable external interrupt 0. So this bit is set to 1 by program to enable interrupt 0 and cleared to 0 to disable INT0 interrupt. Then bit number 1, ET0, enable timer 0 overflow interrupt. So this bit is set to 1 by program to enable timer 0 overflow interrupt. Clear to 0, disable timer overflow interrupt. Then bit number 2, EX1, enable external interrupt 1, set to 1 by program to enable interrupt 1 interrupt. Clear to 0 to disable interrupt 1. Then bit number 3, ET1, enable timer 1 overflow interrupt, set to 1 by program to enable timer 1 overflow interrupt. Clear to 0 to disable timer 1 overflow interrupt. Then fourth bit, ES, enable serial port interrupt, set to 1 by program to enable serial port interrupt. Clear to 0 to disable serial port interrupt. Then bit number 5, reset for future use. Then bit number 6, this is also not implemented. So 5 and 6 not implemented, not used. Then bit number 7, that is EA, enable interrupt bit, clear to 0 by program to disable all the interrupts, and set to 1 to permit individual interrupt to the enabled by the enable bit. Okay, so this is about interrupt enable register details. The next one, interrupt priority register. So this is also a 8-bit register. Starting from D0 to D7, D0 is nothing but PX0, that is priority of external interrupt 0. This bit is set or cleared by program. Then bit 1, PT0, priority of timer 0 overflow interrupt. This bit is set or cleared by program. Then bit 2, PX1, priority of external interrupt 1. So this is set or cleared by program. Then bit number 3, PT1, priority of timer 1, overflow interrupt, set or cleared by program. Then PS, so PS is nothing but priority of serial port interrupt, priority of serial port interrupt, set or cleared by program. Then PT2, PT2 is nothing but reserved for future purpose. Then 6 and 7, not used, not implemented. Okay, so these are the details of interrupt priority special function registers. The interrupt priority register, that is IP, bits determine If any interrupt is to have high or low priority, bits set to 1 give the accompanying interrupt a high priority, 0 assigns a low priority. Interrupts with a high priority can interrupt another interrupt with a lower priority. So the lower priority interrupt continues after the higher is finished. The interrupt structure of 8051 provides two levels of the interrupt priority for its sources of interrupt. Each interrupt source can be programmed to have one of these two levels using the interrupt priority registers IP. The different sources of interrupt programmed to have the same level of priority. Further, it follows a sequence of priority under the level shown here. IE0, that is external interrupt 0, so this is highest priority. Then TE0, timer 0, this is also highest priority. Then IE1, external interrupt 1, this is also highest priority. Then TE1, timer 1, this is also highest priority. Then RI or TI, that is a serial port interrupt, reduces the lowest priority level. So these are the details of interrupt priority special function registers.